Hi, good morning. Welcome to SSV IIT online classes. Today we are going to discuss about analytical geometry, class 8. In previous class we discussed distance and its formulae proof. Now we are going to discuss about section formula using the distance formula. Listen, what is a section formula? Let us AB is a line segment and a point P in between A and B, then P dividing AB internally in some ratio means let us take AB is M, PB as N, then P dividing AB in the ratio M is to N. If we know A and B coordinates, then how to find the P coordinates? We have a derivative for this. Let us draw two mutually perpendicular lines which are known as X and Y. Its intersection is known as origin. Let us take a point A, X1, Y1, and a point B, X2, Y2. By joining them, we will get a line segment, and mark a point P on AB line segment and its coordinate, let x comma y. We want to find the coordinates of P x comma y. Let draw perpendiculars from A to x axis, then it intersect x at L. From P to perpendicular to x axis, then it intersect at M. From B also we can draw a perpendicular, then it intersects at N. These are the perpendiculars which are drawn from A, P, B to X axis. And draw a horizontal line or parallel to X axis from A to intersect the P, M. Means here we get a perpendicular. Similarly, we can draw another parallel line to X axis from P to intersect BN, which intersect at C and D. Clearly we know that ACP is a right-angle triangle, we have C 90 degrees. PDB is a right-angle triangle, D is equal to 90 degrees. Means triangle ACP, triangle PDB are right-angle triangles which are similar by using inclusion, and triangle ACP and triangle PDB, C is equal to D is equal to 90. And observe, this is a line AB. Here observe, angle A, angle P, which are equal based on corresponding angles. These two are parallel, which are perpendicular to the same lines AL, PM, BN, which are perpendicular to X axis. Means perpendiculars, perpendiculars are parallel. So these three vertical lines are parallel. So A, P are equal angles by using transversal property, corresponding angles. So angle A is equal to angle P, corresponding angles. So by using AA similarity condition, triangle ACP similar to triangle PDB. If two triangles are similar, their corresponding sides are in proportion. Corresponding sides are in proportion. Means which are the corresponding sides? First of all, here AP, I am taken here AP length M and PB length N. So similarly, corresponding sides are in proportion. Which are the corresponding sides? AP by PB is equal to, and AC by PD, that is equal to the third side, PC by BD. But we don't know the values of AC, PD, PC, BD. So let us find observe here we have a x1 y1 means it is at a distance from x axis to y1 means it is y1 and at a distance from y axis to x coordinate that is x1. Similarly point P means this is y and this is x. So observe here OL is equal to x1. I am writing here OL is equal to x1. Similarly AL is equal to y1. AL is equal to y1. Here observe PM is equal to, it is known as y coordinate value, y, its value y, and which are from y axis means OM is equal to x. OM is equal to x. From these two we will find LM or AC. LM or AC. AC is equal to LM is equal to x minus x1. Then similarly x minus x1. Here we have PM is equal to y. So CM is equal to y1. So by differentiating these two, PC is equal to means y minus y1. Y minus y1. Here also we have PD means B coordinates x2, y2 means ON is equal to x2. ON is equal to x2 and BN is equal to y2. BN is equal to y2. Then BD value means y2. Listen. BN is equal to y2 total. Here we have DN. DN means which is known as PM. PM value y. Y. So BD is equal to y2 minus y. BD is equal to y2 minus y. Now we want to find PD value. PD means observe. ON value x2. PD is equal to observe. ON minus OM. ON value x2. OM value x. x2 minus x. Its value x2 minus x. By using these values, by substituting in the statement, we will get the sum values. AP by PD. AP value M. M by N is equal to AC by PD, AC value x minus x1 by PD, PD value x2 minus x, x2 minus x, that is equal to PC by PD, that is equal to PC, PC value y minus y1 by BD value, BD, y2 minus y. So, by taking two conditions, we will get individual value. First of two conditions I am taking. M by N is equal to x minus x1 by x2 minus x by two. Cross multiplication. Mx2 minus mx is equal to nx minus nx1. By transporting, mx2 plus nx1 is equal to nx plus mx. By taking x comma m plus n. So mx2 plus nx1 by m plus n is equal to x. X means coordinate of P. X coordinate of P. Similarly, by taking first and third conditions, m by n is equal to y minus y1 by y2 minus y1 by cross multiplication, m by 2 minus m y is equal to n y minus n y 1. M y 2 plus n y 1. Transporting this side. Then we will get y into m plus n. Then m y 2 plus n y 1 by m plus n is equal to y, which is known as y coordinate of P. Therefore, the coordinates of point P which dividing AB in the ratio m is to n is P, x comma y is equal to mx2 plus nx1 by m plus n, m by 2 plus n by 1 by m plus n. And by using this condition, we will prove another one. Listen, here P is dividing AB internally in the ratio m is to n. Similarly, we will find the coordinates of P which was dividing externally. For example, AB is a line segment and a point P which is exterior to the AB line segment. Then we will take AP as M and BP as N. By using same condition, by using this formula, we will prove external intersection of the P x comma y mx2 minus nx1 by m minus n, m by 2 minus n by 1 by m minus n, which is known as P dividing externally in the ratio m is to n. And we have one more example for internally dividing. A 4 comma minus 3, B 8 comma 5, which was dividing in the ratio 3 is to 1. For example, here it is M, it is N. Then P x comma y is equal to formula mx2 plus nx1 by m plus n, comma m by 2 plus n by 1 by m plus n. Here x1 by 1, x2 by 2. By substituting the values, m means 3, x2 8, plus n means 1, x1 value 4, by 3 plus 1. And 3 into y2 value 5, plus 1 into minus 3, by 3 plus 1. 8 is 24, plus 4 by 4, 3 5 is 15, minus 3 by 4, 24 plus 4, 28, 28 by 4, comma 15 minus 3, 12 by 4, 4 7 is 4 3 is. So the coordinates of P which dividing AB given line segment in the ratio 3 is to 1 is known as 7 comma 3. For example, the last one, if the given line segment is divided by P in the ratio 1 is to 1, where M is equal to N, M is equal to N, then by using this condition, observe, M is equal to N means M1, N1, M plus N, we will get same values by taking comma. For example, the coordinates of P x comma y will become x1 plus x2 by 2, comma y1 plus y2 by 2, which is known as midpoint formula. So thank you. In next class we will discuss about the one more section formula and examples. Thank you.